Please stand.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome to St. Ignatius. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. The waters of baptism. Louis died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and if you pass through raging waters in the sea, you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell and death, your side, know that I am with you through it all. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest.
Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant, who has gone to his rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. Now we have the eulogy. We invite Louis.
My father had a saying, "The best I ever made." It mostly referred to the food he cooked. After making it, he would taste it and tell you it was the best he ever made. Or sometimes he would wait for you to say it, as it was usually true, because he cared so much and always put the effort in to make it the best he ever made. The best he ever made was not vain as it sounded, though. It was because he was doing it for you, whoever he was cooking for. Each time he wanted it to be the best he ever made for you to enjoy. It was the gift he could give to make you happy. And he succeeded. Look around you. These are the people that he made happy. Whether it was food or his humor, he always wanted to get that smile and that satisfaction from giving you the best he ever could, the best of himself. Think of his jokes and laugh, his stories and smile. Know that in your company, friendship, and love, it was the best he ever made. Miss you, Dad.
Thank you, Luis, for your beautiful words of remembrance. Now, let us prepare for the readings from the Holy Scripture. We invite Jeanette and Debbie for the readings.
A reading from the book of, There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to uproot the plant. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to tear down, and a time to build. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones, a time to gather them. A time to embrace, and a time to be far from embraces. A time to seek, and a time to lose. A time to keep, and a time to cast away. A time to rend, and a time to sow. A time to be silent, and a time to speak. A time to love, a time to hate. A time of war, and a time of peace. What advantage has the worker from his toil? I have considered the task which God has appointed for all to be busied about. The Lord has made everything appropriate to its time and has put the timeless into their hearts without one's ever discovering from beginning to end the work which God has done. The word of God.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd. waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil. For you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the book of Revelation. And I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, blessed are the dead who from now on die in the Lord. Blessed indeed, says the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, for their works follow them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. With you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Martha said to Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you. Jesus said to her, your brother will rise. Martha said to him, I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day. Jesus told her, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? She said to him, yes, Lord, I have come to believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you. We are united with you today in sorrow at the death of Louis. We confront the reality of death with its pain and sorrow. We are sad and helpless before death, but we are not without hope. God is with us, with God in our side. Let us try to understand the meaning of life and death. And in a very special way, let us entrust lost souls into God's hand. My friends, in today's gospel, we listen a brief discussion between Jesus and Martha, whose brother Lazarus has died. Later, we read that when Jesus came to know about the passing of one of his best friends, Lazarus, he decided to visit the family, Bethany. But it took 4 days for Jesus to come to the family to be with them in their grief. When Martha came to know about Jesus' visit, she came out and received Jesus. But as good friends, Martha started to complain about Jesus' absence during the passing of her brother. And Jesus, what was Jesus' response? Jesus was listening to her. Jesus was consoling, patiently allowing her to express all her grief. And once she shared all her feelings with Jesus, Jesus simply asked this question: do you believe that I am the life and the resurrection? And once she professed her life, her faith in Jesus' authority over life and the power to bring people back to life, Jesus raised Lazarus to life. My friends, this morning, as we gathered in this beautiful house of God, we are like Martha. We love Louis. That is why we are here. And this moment, God is with you, with us. God is allowing us to tell all our stories, share our feelings, our sadness, maybe our anger. See, it all comes from our grief. We struggle to cope with the sudden passing of Louis. So obviously, all Jesus is here to console us, to listen to us. But friends, during Jesus' public ministry, Jesus never preached a funeral homily. That means whenever Jesus visited a funeral, he raised them back to life. He broke up every funeral he ever attended. They raised them into life. But that doesn't mean that Jesus was like a crazy person, every morning get up and asking, where is death? So then go and raise all those people back to life. No. Only a couple of occasions, Jesus did this miracle. What's the purpose of it? To prove that death is not the final word. If death is the final word, there is no resurrection. There is no option to back to life. But Jesus has authority. He's the life and the resurrection. And Jesus bring people back to life. And today, we share the same faith. Jesus is asking us, do you believe that I am the life and the resurrection? And what is your response? And if you say yes, my dear friends, that strengthen your heart, your faith, that helps Louis, that helps your faith journey as well. And thank you for the beautiful words of remembrance. And I came to know that Louis always liked to say that the best I ever made. You know, that is wonderful. You know, what comes to my mind is that, you know, every time he cooks something or he is with the people, he always tried to give his best. His best. It is more than comparison, but it is more of his commitment to you. He respected and he gave everything. You know, when you cook, you not only use some ingredients, but you cook with your love. You add your love, and that become delicious. The food become delicious. And this time, Louis gave us a lot of good memories. I'm sure that that is his legacy. He touched your life, and you remember him forever. But you know, just I bring your attention to now to Louis and his conversation with the God. What God will tell Louis when he meets him? I would say that God would say that the best I ever made. My dear friends, we are created by our loving God, uniquely created with our own special qualities and gifts that make us precious in the sight of our Creator. When God looks at us, he sees beyond our flaws and imperfections. He sees the beauty in our souls, the potential in our heart, and the capacity for love and goodness that resides within us. Each one of us is a masterpiece, carefully designed and crafted by the hands of the loving God who delights in all that we do. No matter what challenges we may face or mistakes we may make, God's love for us remains constant and unwavering. My dear friends, when you remember Louis, you remember his words, "The best I ever made." In the same way, God is telling us repeatedly, not only to Louis, but to us as well, "The best I ever made." Remember this, when we compare ourselves with other people, or when we think about our past mistakes, maybe we may say that, "Oh, I'm not good, I'm not great." But remember, God never make a mistake. Our life is not a mistake. Our choices are maybe a mistake. But God always gives us an opportunity to come back to him. Never complain that my family is not good, or I don't have enough money, or my school, or my friends. No. You are created by God. The best he ever made. And he has a plan for us. All. For all of us, he has a plan. Are we listening to God? Are we surrender ourselves to God? That makes a big, big difference in our life. My dear friends, finally, today, you know that as a Catholic, today is known as Spy Wednesday. Spy Wednesday, because Judas, he decided to betray Jesus. He made a deal with the high priest to betray Jesus. And with a sign that we so fond of, we consider holy and so fond of our life. That is a kiss. Kiss is a sign of love and affection for us. And Judas used the same kiss, the symbol, the expression to betray our Lord. And what happened to Judas? He did that for a momentary comforts or pleasure or money. But What happened to him? He lost his life. Then there is another character we see, especially we reflect on during this time. Peter. And what happened to Peter? Peter rejected Jesus, not only once or twice, three times. But he came back to Jesus. He repented. My dear friends, Judas, he was always focused on God's punishment. He knew that he'd been doing a lot of mistake. So he was so afraid of God's punishment, intervention in his life. So he was afraid of God. Then what about Peter? He denied, but he knew God's love. When Judas was focused on God's wrath on him or focused on punishment, Peter, he focused on God's love. Peter's life ended in, he regained life. He repented and came back to Jesus. And Judas, he was afraid of God and he ended up in, he hanged himself. It's a lesson for us, especially during this Holy Week. Are we scared of God? Are we aware of Jesus' love for us? Remember Louis Wade, the best I ever made. Jesus is repeating us, the best I ever made. We are masterpiece. God will never make a mistake. That is our faith. That is our hope. That is the reason for being here in this morning. We strongly and honestly believe that Louis received an embrace of God and saying that, Louis, I love you and you are the best I ever made. My dear friends, in great trust and hope in God's mercy, let us entrust Louis into God's hand. May our good Lord reward him for all the good things in his life. The way he believed, the way he shared his love with the family and friends, the way he gave time, talents, the treasure for others. And may our good Lord forgive all his human weaknesses. On behalf of St. Ignatius Parish, I express our Christian compassion and condolences to the family and friends. May his soul rest in peace. Amen. My dear friends, now we have the time for the prayer of the faithful, and your response is, hear our prayer. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. In baptism, Louis received the light of Christ, scatter the darkness now, and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Our brother Louis was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy. Many friends and members of families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy. Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy. In union with the risen Lord, we pray for the living and the dead, confident that our prayer will be heard. We especially pray for Lucia, Adelaide, Fosco, and Regina. We, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ. Grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. Now we have the presentation of gifts. We invite Louis Pinto III, Jeanette, and Daniel.
Hour of death. Amen.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of his holy church. Be near, O Lord, we pray to your servant Louis, on whose funeral day we offer you the sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to him, or any human fault have affected him, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel or sit. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and did willingly in his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, all the clergy, religious, and your holy people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially Louis. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, martyrs, saints, St. Ignatius of Loyola, and all those who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from it. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power and glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us
Behold, the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. Now we have the Holy Communion, and we invite Catholics And those who are prepared to receive Jesus Christ may come forward. All others may come for a special blessing with their arms crossed.
One bread, one body, one Lord of all, one cup of blessing which we strength, and we will fly like the
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Louis, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Once again, I'd like to express our prayers and condolences to the family. As we all know that in various ways he supported the community, especially as a member of the fire department. And also, he fed your body, am I right? Prepared good food. But you have a responsibility right now, now onwards, to feed his soul. Because our faith teaches that after our death, we cannot do anything for ourselves. Okay, so, but all our loved ones can do a lot, especially one of the best ways to express your love for Louis is to offer masses for him. Offer masses for him. Don't forget. Don't allow the death to terminate all the good memories. Offer masses for him, and especially this is a holy week, and when you celebrate Easter, you truly believe that he is alive and he is with Jesus, and may that Jesus, the risen Christ, help you to go through this difficult time and help all children and grandchildren and friends and family. Always remember that he is listening the word, I have made the best. Okay, I made the best. That is Jesus' words of welcoming for Louis. Let us trust in him and pray for him. And also special Anne Marie Martin from Florida. She contacted me several times to speak about Louis, and a special condolences prayers from Anne Marie. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Louis, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see him again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
May songs of the angels welcome you and guide you along your way. May the smiles of the martyrs greet your own as darkness turns into day.
To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Louis, your servant. In the sight of this world, He is now dead. In your sight, may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Now, I especially thank Mariel for your wonderful music, Bobby and Richard for assisting this mass, and Donna for your presence and your help for the family. Thank you, everyone. And now, in peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
You dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angels he's given